Hello everyone, welcome to the course of Microwave Engineering. In today's class, we will be learning about measurement of attenuation. So firstly, we need to know what is attenuation of a signal. So this attenuation of a signal is generally done by attenuators. So these attenuators will be somewhat like fixed attenuators as well as variable attenuators. Okay, this type of fixed attenuators and variable attenuators and the concept of attenuation we have already seen in the previous units. So let us again recall what is an attenuation of a signal. Suppose a microwave energy or a microwave signal is passing through a waveguide, let us say. Okay, this particular microwave signal will be having its own power. As the signal is traveling from one end to the other end, the power present in the microwave signal may vary. Okay. So let us say, as the signal is traveling from one end to the other end in a waveguide, let us say that particular microwave signal has got a more power. Okay, so we will be attenuating this particular signal in such a way that the power of the signal will be reduced to our desired quantity or the desired requirement. Okay, and without affecting the quality of the signal. So whenever an attenuation is done for a signal, the power will be reduced or altered according to the requirement without affecting the quality of the signal. So this type of attenuations can be achieved by few devices as well as components. So all the microwave devices and components always provide some degree of attenuation. That means whatever the signal is passing through that particular components or the devices, okay, that signal will get attenuated at some point of time. That means the signal, the power present in the signal gets altered. Okay, but using an attenuator, okay, we can get our desired power present in the particular microwave signal. So generally an attenuation of signal is nothing but the power present in the signal will be cut down or increased or altered to the required or the desired power, okay, or according to the requirement without affecting the quality of the signal. Okay, so now the attenuation can be calculated this way. So the attenuation is the ratio of input power to the output power and is normally expressed in decibels. So how much power is that particular signal is carrying at the time of input and how much power that the signal is carrying at the time of coming as an output. Okay, the ratio of these two, the input power as well as the output power, is expressed in decibels. So the attenuation in decibels dBs is given by 10 log P in by P out, where P in is the input power and P out is the output power. So what is the power whenever the signal is entering into the waveguide and what is the power obtained whenever it is leaving the waveguide at the output end? That is what we are measuring, okay, to get the attenuation in decibels or dBs. Okay, now to measure the attenuation or the amount of attenuation can be measured by two methods. One is power ratio method, another one is RF substitution method. Okay, so let's see the methods, two methods, one by one, and let's see which method is more effective. Okay, coming to the power ratio method, this method involves the measuring of both input power and the output power, but with and without the device whose attenuation is to be measured. Now let us say we need to calculate the input power. Okay, so in order to calculate the input power, initially we will be transmitting the microwave signal throughout the bench setup without the device connected to that particular bench setup. So whichever the device we want to calculate the attenuation, that device is not connected initially. So without the device we will be just transmitting a microwave signal and we will be calculating how much that microwave signal has got the power, okay, at the output end. That is the step setup one. Okay, now in the setup two we will be connecting a device to the bench setup whose attenuation is to be measured. Now in the setup two we will be connecting a particular device to the microwave bench setup and after the connection of this microwave device to the microwave bend setter, okay, this microwave signal is passed through that particular device. Now, this device will attenuate that particular microwave signal, and at the output end, it will be received in, it will be receiving the particular power reading. Okay. Now, setup one is considered as an input power, and setup two is considered as output power. Okay. Or the setup one is considered as P1, and the setup two is considered as P2. Okay. Now, the power measured in the each setup P1 and P2 will be calculating the attenuation. That means, as we have seen the earlier formula, attenuation in decibels is nothing but P in by P out. Here, according to our setup, P in is the setup one, which is nothing but P1, and P out is the setup two, which is nothing but P2. Now, in order to calculate the attenuation of that, we will be calculating the ratio of P1 by P2. Okay. So, setup one, that is P1, is nothing but without connection of the device, we will be calculating the power of a microwave signal. Setup two, that is P2, is nothing but the power of an device where we will be connecting that particular microwave device, and the microwave signal is passed through that, and we will be calculating the power. Now, the outputs of P1 and the P2 will be calculated with respect to the ratio, which will be giving the attenuation measurement. Okay, this is what's happening in a power ratio method. So let's see the setup one. We can see here microwave source is connected to a frequency meter. Frequency meter is connected to a slotted line. The other end of the slotted line is terminated. Now this slotted line is connected to the crystal detector, and this crystal detector is connected to the thermistor mount. This thermistor mount, as we have seen in the previous classes, it will be calculating the power. Okay, so it will be calculating the power, and that power will be shown on the power meter, and the readings of that power, which is given by the thermistor mount, will be shown on the power meter. Now, in the setup one, there is no particular microwave device connected to check the attenuation. Initially, we are just using a bend setter, okay, to calculate the power, which we are taking it as P1, which we are considering it as P input. Now, the microwave source generates the microwave signal. It goes through a frequency meter and slotted line, and at the slotted line, it will be detected by the crystal detector, and that particular power is taken by this particular thermistor mount, and the values calculated by this, or the values produced by this thermistor mount, will be generated on the power meter over here. Okay, this is calculated as P1 or the P input. Now, coming to the setup two, similarly like setup one, we'll be having a bend setter, but here we'll be connecting a device, a microwave device, whose attenuation is to be measured. Now, the same microwave source will be generating the microwave signal or a frequency. That signal will be passed through frequency meter, and here, after the frequency meter, that particular signal will be passed through this particular device, and this device will be having some sort of attenuation. That means whatever the signal is coming or passing through this particular device, okay, the power of that particular signal will be altered. It may be high or low, we don't know. Okay, now, after the passing that particular microwave signal through this device, we will be taking that signal, and through slotted line, we will be detecting through a crystal detector, and thermistor mount takes the readings of that particular signal given from this device, and through power meter, we will be reading how much power is produced after traveling through this particular device after the attenuation process. Okay. So, after the attenuation process, how much power is there in that particular microwave signal, we will be calculating through this thermistor mount, and the readings are distributed on, or dissipated on this, or projected on this particular power meter. Now, the power which is calculated after the attenuation present in the device will be considered as P2, which we are considering it as P out. Okay. Now, so the ratio of So at P1 or the PIN, we got a value, and at P2 or the Pout, we got a value. And in order to calculate this power ratio method, we will be calculating with respect to, okay, 10 log P1 by P2. That is how we will be achieving the attenuation, okay? So this power ratio method is somewhat a long process, and this drawback of the method is it will be, in the two cases, the signal will be detected by the crystal detector and the power reading is measured on the power meter, okay? And due to the non-linear characteristics, the attenuation calculated will not be very much accurate. There will be a lot of losses. There will be a lot of non-linear characteristics. There won't be the same equal length or the values, okay? So as we are going for a two process, setup one and setup two, after calculating the whole ratio using a power ratio method, the attenuation what we achieve may not be accurate, okay? Now, coming to the RF substitution method, this method overcomes the drawback of power ratio method since we are measuring the attenuation at a single power position. So using a single setup, we can measure the attenuation of a particular microwave signal present in the waveguide. Okay. So this method consists of measuring the output power whose attenuation is to be measured. So using a single setup and by the output power measured, we can calculate or measure the attenuation, okay, very much easily. Okay. So this network is replaced by a precision calibrated attenuator, which can be adjusted to obtain the same power P. So here in this particular method or the setup, we will be using a precisely calibrated attenuator, which can be rotated to our user requirements. And we can alter the power present in the microwave signal. And we can also attenuate the power present in the microwave signal, okay, using a single setup itself, okay? So let's see how this setup works. So coming to the RF substitution method, we have a microwave source, okay, which will be generating a microwave signals. That microwave signal is passed through the frequency meter, and this frequency meter, from this frequency meter, the signal goes to the variable attenuator here. So this variable attenuator is nothing but a user can adjust this particular knob, or user can rotate this particular knob to alter the power present in the incoming microwave signal. So whatever the signal is coming from the frequency meter, okay, that power can be altered using this particular variable attenuator, where this variable attenuator can be adjusted by this particular user, okay? So let us say the microwave signal has got a huge power or more power, okay, but which is not required by our setup, okay? Now, using this variable attenuator, we can rotate the knob in such a way that the power of an incoming microwave signal will be attenuated or reduced, okay, without the affecting the signal quality. Now, whenever an attenuator is used, the power of a microwave signal or the incoming microwave signal can be altered, okay, without affecting the quality of a signal. Now, as the signal has got high power, we are using a variable attenuator to adjust that attenuation of signals such that the power of an microwave signal is reduced without affecting the quality of the signal. Now, this particular microwave signal is sent through the slotted line, and the slotted line, which is connected to this particular detector, is connected to a power meter through which the readings of a power of a microwave signal which is attenuated will be measured. Okay, so this termination is nothing but we are closing the whole setup till this end. Okay, so variable attenuator is nothing but it can be altered by the user for adjusting the power or for reducing the power present in a microwave signal without affecting the quality of its particular microwave signal. Okay. So we will be having a various types of attenuators, fixed attenuator and variable attenuator, mostly in a bench setup. We will be seeing a variable attenuators where the user can attenuate the particular incoming frequency according to the desired requirement. Okay.